found while either meeting with vets that come to see me in Albany or while I move around the state is the lack of information. All of these items, they're the toolbox. You may not need to use the hammer, the screwdriver, the plier right now, but it's imperative that all of our vets are aware of what resources are in their toolbox. And by having these various informational briefings, it allows them, when they need the services, how to go to that particular item. Some of our vets are not in CUNY, but if they decide to go to CUNY, they should know what's available for them. Some of them are not looking for any particular employment, but if they are looking for employment, they should know where to go to find the employment needs that they have, and that goes to any other form of resources that they need. That's the goal of what we want to accomplish. Before we can start the process of adding new items to the list, we first must have our vets aware of what items are on the list. And there are
about 2 million young American men and women have served their country either in Iraq, Afghanistan, or both. We're up to almost 2 million Americans. And out of that, about 240,000 are now veterans and using the post-9/11 GI Bill to go back to school. I met many of you beforehand. Enrollment is up at all our colleges with veterans returning from Iraq and Afghanistan. And this just gives you some perspective. Now, from my perspective, there's an unfortunate side to that, and I'm just going to lay it out. I don't think there's enough of them coming to school in New York. I'm just going to lay it right out there. When you look at our share of that benefit, it's about 2.5% of the total figure.